After a 10-year journey, Rosetta and Philae had finally reached their destination, Comet 67P, Churyumov Gerasimenko. Rosetta's exciting mission was to follow the comet as it traveled around the Sun. She would learn all about the comet and how it changes as it gets warmer and warmer, while Philae would visit the surface. But as she got closer, Rosetta realized that the comet was much more complex than people had thought, using telescopes from far away. It almost looked like two comets stuck together, and from some angles its shape was really rather strange. Rosetta had to steer several times to get closer and closer to the comet. The closer Rosetta and Philae got to this strange world, the more wonders they discovered on its surface. There were craters, cliffs, and boulders the size of houses. Rosetta spent many weeks studying the surface of the comet, sending lots of information back to Earth. She also started to analyze the dust and gas around the comet. But there was always one question in the back of her mind. Where was Philae going to land? No spacecraft had ever attempted to make a soft touchdown on a comet. Philae started to pick some of his favorite spots on the comet, but Rosetta had to check with the experts back home. They thought long and hard and eventually found the best spot for Philae to land. Then Rosetta had to plan the exact route around the comet to make sure that Philae would land in the right place. Soon it was time for Philae to make the final preparations for his great adventure. He checked that he had everything he needed to land on the comet. Both spacecraft couldn't wait any longer. The whole world would be watching as Rosetta and Philae got ready for their biggest challenge yet.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The I've been studying these things for 40 years, and we've never had an opportunity like this to look at a nucleus close up and to see what processes are going on the surface, how sublimation actually works at the surface, what's the interior structure, because the interior structure is how bodies formed in the solar system 4.6 billion years ago.
So knowing how this comet formed will tell us about how the Earth formed?
Yes, it'll help us with understanding the process of accretion. And accretion is frozen into the comet. It's never been melted, it's never been heated. And when we can study the particles close up, we'll actually understand how particles came together in the solar nebula. And that's a first step that to understanding the how larger bodies formed also. Thank you. Rosetta is photographing the comet, taking spectra in the UV and the IR. It's Sam's instrument is working to detect coma gases that are coming off. There's other instruments that analyze the coma gases directly, and there's a dust instrument that counts dust particles. There's another dust instrument that actually breaks the particles up into their constituent atoms and analyzes the composition of the solid material that's coming off. There's instruments that are measuring the interaction of the comet nucleus with the solar wind. So we're studying the comet in every way we can possibly think of. Thank you. The lander has another 10 instruments that, among other things, dig into the surface and bring back material for compositional analysis. It'll measure the solar wind interaction right at the surface of the comet and so on. And of course, return spectacular photos of the comet.
Thank you. Thank you.
After a 10-year journey, Rosetta and Philae had finally reached their destination, Comet 67P, Churyumov Gerasimenko. Rosetta's exciting mission was to follow the comet as it traveled around the Sun. She would learn all about the comet and how it changes as it gets warmer and warmer, while Philae would visit the surface. But as she got closer, Rosetta realized that the comet was much more complex than people had thought, using telescopes from far away. It almost looked like two comets stuck together, and from some angles its shape was really rather strange. Rosetta had to steer several times to get closer and closer to the comet. The closer Rosetta and Philae got to this strange world, the more wonders they discovered on its surface. There were craters, cliffs, and boulders the size of houses. Rosetta spent many weeks studying the surface of the comet, sending lots of information back to Earth. She also started to analyze the dust and gas around the comet. But there was always one question in the back of her mind. Where was Philae going to land? No spacecraft had ever attempted to make a soft touchdown on a comet. Philae started to pick some of his favorite spots on the comet. But Rosetta had to check with the experts back home. They thought long and hard and eventually found the best spot for Philae to land. Then Rosetta had to plan the exact route around the comet to make sure that Philae would land in the right place. Soon it was time for Philae to make the final preparations for his great adventure. He checked that he had everything he needed to land on the comet. Both spacecraft couldn't wait any longer. The whole world would be watching as Rosetta and Philae got ready for their biggest challenge yet.